Welcome, my friends. Thank you so much for joining me. I welcome you back to part 3 of my gentle series for beginners. In today's video, we are going to be targeting stretches for the low back and hips, an area that can get really compressed and tight, especially if you spend a lot of time sitting. So go ahead and like this video. You could even add it to your list of favorites so you can come back and practice anytime you need to get relief. Don't forget to leave your comments below and subscribe to the channel. And once you're all set, we are going to begin our practice today sitting. So as you find yourself in a comfortable seat, we're going to start by bringing the soles of your feet together and letting your knees open out towards the sides. Now, if your hips are very tight, it might be helpful to sit on a cushion or a blanket, something that will lift your hips up a little higher than your knees. So that will make it a lot easier for you to sit up tall and find some relaxation in the hips. So as you get yourself situated, we're gonna hold on to your ankles in front of you. Then lift up through your spine and feel a sense rolling your shoulders down your back. Then lift up through the crown of your head so you feel some engagement through your core and all the way up through your spine. Now we're gonna take a deep breath in right here. Full big inhale. And as you exhale, slowly begin to lean forward, taking it to your edge, then gently roll your shoulders and head down. And on your next inhale, we're gonna roll your spine back up to center. As you come to the top of your breath, you'll come to the top of your pose. Then exhale and gently fold it forward, letting your head and neck relax. Then again, we'll inhale to come up, unrolling your spine all the way to the top. Then exhale and fold it down. So you can take a few more rounds, following with the flow, the rhythm of your own breath, letting the inhale lift you up, and the exhale will fold you down. So we'll just take a couple more rounds on your own timing, feeling into that stretch. And on your next exhale, we're just gonna pause, folding forward over your legs so we can start to breathe here. Just giving yourself a moment to be with this stretch. Notice where the sensation arises. What areas do you feel stretching? See if you can send your breath to those places. And find a little bit more of a sense of release. And we'll slowly begin to unroll your spine. Just let yourself move slow and gentle. Taking your time, we'll gently rise back up to sitting. Okay, now we're going to move through a sequence of stretches from one side to the other. And if there's any of these stretches that feel especially good to you, put them in your memory bank so you can practice anytime. Now we'll start by extending your right leg out in front of you. And just station your left foot to the inside of your right thigh. And we'll inhale to lift nice and tall, reaching your fingertips high, lift up out of your waist. And as you exhale, we'll gently fold your body forward,
let your hands come down towards the floor as you relax the back of your neck and let your head fold down. Now, as you breathe into this stretch, don't worry about how far forward you can fold. The most important thing here is feeling into the stretch. So whatever your range of motion is, dive into the sensation and let yourself work into this stretch, letting each breath guide you deeper and deeper. And we'll inhale and lift your spine halfway up, extending through your chest. Then step your left hand to the outside of your right foot. Glide your right fingertips back and twist your spine towards the right side. So you push into the mat to give yourself some leverage. Get a good deep twist here. Now maintain the twist and slowly start to fold back down over that right leg. So now we're accessing a deeper stretch into the IT band and that band of tissue along the outer edge of your thigh and hip. So take another full breath here, working that rotation in your spine as you release and fold over your right leg. Then we'll slowly rise, make your way all the way back up to center. Now here, we're just gonna adjust on your mat slightly, opening your hips towards the left side. So now we open up the shape and start to access a stretch along that inner right thigh. Now let's reach your left arm up and over. Carving the space overhead, you begin to reach towards your right toes. Now again, don't worry about how far you can go. What you really want to focus on is that deep stretch along the left side of your waist. See if you can extend through the left arm, increasing the stretch as you reach through your left fingertips. Then slowly make your way back up, and you're going to walk your hands out in front of you. So just folding right down the middle, bowing forward towards the earth. Try to keep those right toes rotated up towards the sky as you fold your heart forward and deepen the stretch along the inner hip and thigh. So I'm going to take some slow, deep breaths here as you work your way into this stretch. And when you're ready, we'll slowly walk your hands back in and press yourself all the way up. Now, circle your right leg behind you. So you'll slightly bend into that right knee. Then place your left hand to the floor, and we're going to carve the space like a big ice cream scoop, circling that right arm up and around, reaching towards the upper back corner of your space. So we get a deep rotation, twisting through your spine as you reach those right fingertips around. You may even start to lift your hips, pressing your hips forward to deepen the stretch. And slowly begin to make your way
back to front. So we're gonna untwist. Then circle this right leg around and step your foot to the outside of your left leg. So now we're going to prepare for a seated twist. So you'll wrap your left arm around your right knee and hug that knee in towards your shoulder. So we give it a good deep squeeze. Then place your right hand to the floor and use that hand to give you a little leverage to rotate your heart around to that right side. Still hugging the left knee in, or the right knee, still hugging that knee in towards your left shoulder as you rotate through your spine. Then we'll slowly begin to return to the front. And now what we're going to do is take this entire shape with the legs and just rotate it 90 degrees. So place your hands down to the floor behind you and you'll just rotate that left foot flat down to the floor. So now you have a nice figure four shape in your legs. Now press into your hands and lift up your chest so you find length and extension in your spine. Then simultaneously begin to press your right knee open to the side. So you really start to target and isolate the outer right hip. Now you can get a little more juice out of this shape if you start to gently and slowly rock your left knee from side to side. Just exploring a little bit of movement there. You can discover if there's any places that feel extra good. Anything that feels really nice to stretch. So just give yourself a little chance to explore and play around and find the stretch that feels the best.